let's face it, gay boys fucking gossip. They're always gonna be something around about you. Shrug it off.
It started with Cody, and now all my friends are gay, and I can't help it.
A lot of the shit that you hear about yourself is fucking hilarious. No skin off of my back. If people aren't gonna get to know me.
And girls are always like, give me some of your gay friends. It doesn't work like that. Make a friend, and if he's gay, sweet. If not, fucking whatever.
And if you don't actually know who a person is, then how can you be their friend?
They get all poofy and pretty, and then they kill each other.
Very hard to find a guy that just wants to be himself and not what everyone else expects him to be.
This world was not explained to me at all.
Gay boys fucking gossip.
The Bible is the word of God. We don't have to have a general assembly about what we believe. It's written in the Bible. All right, so we don't have to debate about what we should think about homosexual activity. It's written in the Bible.
You have a table, and it's you can invite boys to sit down with you and chat. Do a casual bro. Just a casual one.
I'm Cody. I am, I guess, the loud one, the obnoxious one, the one that's kind of a douchebag. Most people would call me their slutty friend. Although, I'm not embarrassed about that. Let's face it, if you can own something, own it.
Okay. Speaking up and pronounce and project and whatever.
Elocution.
Briss. He is human bait. You dangle him in front of the straight boys and they kind of come wandering out of the woodwork.
A nice 60. Peach schnapps. A little bit of Galliano. Golden pear. I'm placing money on who's going to puke first.
Filming, sorry.
Are you wearing a tie?
I'm Merwin. I'm kinda new. Kinda had a conservative lifestyle. This world definitely was not explained to me at all when I was a kid.
Maybe he could drink some Galliano because we're not clapping. Okay.
It's delicious.
Someone's at the door.
It's the foreigner.
Thanks.
Hello.
Let's see who Nick's gonna go after. What do you think?
Hello, Christian and Madison are just parking the car. This isn't my jacket, it's Merwin's, that's why it's really gay.
Amy and Dave.
Hey, I'm Amy. I love gay boys and they love me. Out of all the girls that have been in the group, I've been here the longest.
Sluttiest.
Brad is gonna be like, I hate everyone. You're all fucking losers. Can I sleep with you?
Fuck off.
No videos.
David. Are you sure it was a girl?
Yeah, sure.
I live on Vapkin cigarettes. Duel. Bad breakup? Bottle liquor. New boy.
Alex is going to be there. Yeah, right.
Where's Alex is still. Oh, okay. And he has to wash it down.
Hey, I'm Alex. It was the night of the dance, New Year's. No one really told me that my ex boyfriend, Duel, would have been there.
Reading me like this.
Yeah, cry?
I think he'll cry. Yeah. Well, wasn't there another ex couple, though?
Carver in half the town.
Girl, get out of my way. I am gonna get up in this video space. Last day in Kelowna. I'm Carver.
Carver's gonna be so over this town because he's going to Vancouver.
This is Maddie and
Krista.
Transsexual over here.
What?
She went, girl!
Hello.
Hello, everyone.
And then Eric showed up.
Chris does not like Eric. Kind of invited Eric.
Awkward.
Eric is this little boy. He's pretty and he knows it. And he kind of expects people to treat him like it. And they do, which is the worst part. Like, I'm not gonna say what. I don't like some of the things he does. I don't like the way that I feel like he treats some people.
Eric, don't touch it. I will change her.
Everyone, relax.
No, we don't want the live calling him by his actual name.
Oh, now I can pay. Yeah, it's a nice change from the phone.
And then she's like, I don't know what's going on for you.
This is where the demons get ready.
In the bathroom.
You spilled that shit on me.
Maybe I'm
fine. The Macarena has never been gayer. I spoke too soon. It got a lot gayer.
Bring a bottle and leave
it in the car. Just
any fucking bottle.
I was really skeptical about going to the dances after Nick's like, all like, you should go to the dances. And I was like,
The dances. One giant hot mess for the boys to actually come out, be boys. All the fights come on, standing ahead.
the dance, he started calling me a dick and a whole bunch of things. Just repetitively, like, girl, you're such a dick. Why do you have to be such a dick? And I didn't even know what I was doing.
Because you're gonna fall.
Tragedy.
No one wants. No.
I need to kill someone.
Talk together!
Whoa,
no.
Don't sit my book.
Hey, take a picture of me.
When danced with a bunch of guys.
My night was just fabulous. And that's the first time I've ever said that. And the last time I'll ever say that. Fabulous. You'll never hear that coming from my golden lips again.
I hate most people at these dances because they are arrogant cunts.
We should be nicer.
Right.
Be nice.
Are you sure that blonde boy was straight? He got me to sit on his lap.
Even three.
I think it was kind of.
Dude, it was oh 3-2-1. Happy New Year.
Last year was like a minute. They like stopped.
I stopped a dyke fight last night. Dyke drama? Like fucking shit. Like don't get angry. Dykes, why do you have to try to fight?
Zach's our new friend who everyone seems to like him and he's really nice. He's really fun.
I saw this and just assumed that you were
going to do my hair.
Oh, okay.
I totally just combed it, flat ironed the bangs, and walked out.
Gotchas is fucking gay because they think that the shit is. They think they're honestly. They think that.
Hey,
fine, it's like son of a bitch.
Gotchas is full of douchebags, fuller than Elton John's closet. All it is a whole bunch of gangsters who just sit around eyeing up the drunkest girl there. To go home and sodomize. Like, they're like, is she drunk enough so I can stick in her poop reel?
I'm pretty sure Merwin would be pretty good at porn.
Yeah.
Porn, really? I don't like dirty things. I don't hear about it. I don't want to. It's not how I was raised.
Don't tell me I'm gonna be good at porn, you douche.
Zach said that, not me.
Well, either.
Barbie, right there. Who's the big Nelly Bottom?
Bottom and top. Even if I was one or the other, why would I say it?
Merwin. He is the most repressed one ever. Really big sweetheart.
Cody. I don't even think there's a word for him. Fun as hell. Holy crap. I've never seen something so horny. Like, no one's safe. At all.
Stop.
Come on, Mom. I love you, Barbie. I love you, Ken. Cody can keep his little analysis in his bedroom.
Chris should definitely just fuck Merwin raw. Merwin would love it for a day and a half.
Fuck, you all suck.
Yeah.
Really, do you?
Yeah.
How was your night with Dane?
Yeah. You get along. What are you up to today?
I'm just heading to the beach to meet up with Merwin for a bit.
You guys, like, what's the deal? Like, he's like stalkerish in love with you.
I'm just like, I'm not ready to date yet. I'm not ready for. Like, I told him that, and he's fine with it.
Chris and Merwin kind of have a thing. I guess we'll see how that works out. Merwin likes him, and Chris is. Well, Chris. So, like I said, I guess we'll see how that works out.
I don't know. Here's the thing about me and Merwin is that we're not together, and we have talked about it. We've had the conversation. I'm not ready to date right now, and he has said that he's fine with it.
You've gone a decade without sex. In this, your semi-relationship, engagement is normal sex in a gay relationship is supposed to happen on the second date.
Not everyone is like you, Cody. I'll see you at Zach's.
Oh, hey, how are you?
Hello.
Nick is interesting. He's British, I'm sold.
Alex's parents are out of town on a cruise this week. So I said he should have people over his house last night.
You should show us how to work out.
Oh, okay. They're only 45 minutes.
Fake.
Oh,
I'm trying.
Well, why not?
Yeah, and who is Zach? That is Zach right there. Zach, give us your birthday smile.
He's 20.
Yes.
I'm trying to be 20? Nice. No, he's not 20.
You're
I'm
21.
Nice. 22.
You're 22? Holy shit.
Hi, Megan. I'm on camera. Yeah,
I've almost had an entire bottle of wine except for next to off the wall.
It went up
the fridge door and everything went flying out.
Turn the fucking video off.
Filming you doing up your pants.
It's the last time you'll see me doing them up. Next time I'll be doing them down.
Chris, I kind of think he has something like a pheromone and everything's drawn to it. He needs to tell people no.
Really now?
Thanks.
I just flirted with.
What the fuck is all with poker face, dammit?
Hey, I'm Scott, and I moved here like a couple of months ago. I met everyone through Carver.
Okay. His fucking shirt matches Sandra. This is the third fucking time that I've seen that happen.
It's 11:30. We're all good and wrecked. So we need to go to the center.
And Nick is here and drinking more wine.
Half hour and feel like.
Yo.
Zach's birthday, and everybody's having a pretty good time.
Who is this, Kyle? We're on our way to level right now. Dude, how was I supposed to know you were leaving at 12:30?
Okay, well, let's do it.
Oh, I am not a bitch.
Woman's not a virgin.
Are you sure?
Oh, wait, no, I mean.
There it is.
What?
I was lying.
By the way,
it's
what?
Yeah. Me and Nick were so drunk that we made out a bunch. I was making out with everybody on that night.
We got thrown out for being too gay.
We did
someone
not
held
get
my hands
out.
And made out with me.
Twice. I made out with everyone.
You make out with me.
You don't want it.
I'm you're mean.
Okay, Chris, you don't want it, so that's why I don't do it.
In a lot of trouble if you don't tone it down.
We've had several times the managers have to come up and talk to us because it's a little bit too gay, you know, with the boys all grinding.
You gotta admit it though, that whole stage was.
No, it doesn't matter about that. It matters about the bump and grind that goes on where people think that they don't have to dance, they can just grab each other's fucking asses.
Boys haven't figured out that there's a difference between going to the clubs and dancing and doing the giant meat market that they like to do.
That's not dancing, that's just being a whore.
I dance,
some
but
people,
I also make
some people
out.
Are just being a whore on the dance floor.
Girl caliber sluttiness right there. That was bad. The meat train?
The gravy train? That little boy in the black, he was
all twinks?
I mean, not all twinks, all twinks.
Being friends with this group has definitely helped me because it's given me a good outlet to like just go and be myself, and like a lot of times at home, I'm not allowed to tell my brothers and sisters. Like, I don't have to pretend to be anything. I just can just be.
Zach,
nobody save me.
Can I get the pills?
I'm not drinking.
And like, when I can see myself, and I can think I'm being unsure.
It's an energy drink.
You're just jealous that you're not.
No, actually, that's like the crab.
Chris and I definitely have a fun relationship. It's definitely on, off. I love him. He's cute. He's fun. He's the same as everybody else. He's awesome. The three, we're going to finish this, and I'm going to try and make myself prettier.
Yeah, that's really.
Let's do our makeup when we get drunk, okay?
Come on, through the teeth, past the gums, through inappropriate touching, here we come.
No, I really get thrown. Oh. That's really, really
that's gross.
That seems good. Good. Happy birthday, I think you're amazing and so sexy and so cute.
Oh my god, boy. Oh, it's your fake birthday.
He's like so solid.
So Andy's this guy that kind of flew in and he wanted to see Chris. So he came here for his birthday weekend, which happened to land on one of those dances.
My birthday is good. Why are you so close? Are you going to the dance?
Yeah, we're going
awesome,
to the
dance.
Awesome,
I'll see you there.
Okay. That's Andy.
Okay,
Ladies and gentlemen,
these boys and girls.
But as long as
you penetrate Scott.
No, I haven't.
No, kids. Would you?
Would I? Could no, because I don't penetrate anybody.
No, but if you had, if it was like the end of the world and you had to penetrate somebody before you died, would you penetrate Scott?
Oh, well, maybe.
Hey, you got a button nose.
What's a button nose?
It's cute. Like a little button.
Ow.
He was kind of capitalizing it on all of Chris's time all night. He was kind of like grinding the crap out of him against the stage. So Zach and I thought it would be fun to go save Chris. So I go in between Chris and Andy. And Andy didn't think it was too funny. He thought it was like a challenge. Like I was like challenging him for Chris and like pushing him out. Like he actually had a chance with Chris.
At the dance, Andy got really testro. He decided to get in Scott's face because Scott was trying to keep him away from Chris.
That boy needs to calm down or someone's gonna kick his ass.
He's like, all of a sudden he just like pushed me and shoved me. He's like, I'm in the fucking army and blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, guy, look at me. I'm gay. Yeah. You're gonna fight the smallest little faggot here? He's at a gay dance. Tell him to be fucking gay.
So Andy's back. Apparently, he went and bought Chris $300 worth of things from the mall.
Like you said, Justin Hoffa. Drew Insta?
Who?
Drew.
Can you believe how much stuff Andy bought me? He told me he was gonna get me in prison and he comes back with this bag. There's like... Dude, there's like $300 worth of stuff in this bag. Whatever, he's in the army, it's government money. Just saying.
Just saying.
Me and Scott hooked up the other night, hey? We made out. How random is that?
Thanks.
What's going on?
We're going to Big White.
Not a good place for what?
Let's cut to go first, just because it'll be cool. I got a sorry card, which is high card, and we're going for low card.
So I just go like this?
Yeah, sure, why not? And
it's the monster.
It means you lose!
If your car is fucked,
they just bought
you're
going
to have to
one.
Pay for it yourself.
No, seriously, this is the fifth car they've bought me.
Really?
Yeah, because I keep killing them. Is Chris at Big White right now?
I think so. I think he's with Scott Darling.
That kind of seems a little bit weird because we don't really like hang out with Scott Darling. That's
seems
weird. Weird, a friend outside of the group?
Yeah, I was going to say that's just foreign to me. It doesn't usually happen. I think I was like the last new person.
You were the last new person.
Isn't that awesome? Oh my god.
It's actually kind of awful. I kind of feel like a douchebag. It doesn't happen on purpose.
It started with Cody and now all my friends are gay and I can't make it stop. And you know what makes me crazy though? When you like, whenever people are like talking about their friends and stuff and like it somehow comes up, like I would talk about one of my friends and his boyfriend or something like that to a girl, it's like, oh my god, you have a gay friend? And like, all my friends are gay, like, it's just, I can't help it. And girls are always like, give me some of your friends, give me some of your gay friends. And
oh my
like,
god, we're not Pokemon, you cannot trade us.
Zach's been talking?
Mm-hmm.
What's Zach been saying?
I think he asked Chris at the dance, something along the lines of he would penetrate me. And like trying to instigate
like,
something.
He was like instigating.
Yeah, he totally was. Yeah, he was trying to like stir something up and get something going.
What a surprise. Did anything happen?
Well, maybe.
So something did happen then.
I was drinking, so.
So you guys made out.
Yeah.
You made out with Chris.
Yeah.
Like, was it mutual? Was it like, hey, I want you, blah blah blah, or was it like?
No, not really. I was just. I don't know. It was just so, happened, and I was just like, okay, this is kind of awkward.
That's actually really fucking funny.
I know, hey?
At least you didn't try and have sex with him, because that wouldn't have happened.
I'm like a gigolo.
You are
booyah!
Hello!
Where
has deportation when you need one.
The people at the door.
Shit here. Tell me if that's okay.
Can you see me? Okay, so I have a question.
What?
Can you tell me the truth?
Yeah.
Okay. So I was talking to Scott. I was told that you were coming on to him and he wasn't so much into it, but you came on to him.
What have you heard?
At your house. I'm not fucking dumb. People tell me shit. Okay, were you hitting on him?
Who told you this?
Scott.
That he wasn't into it?
Well, I just wanted to know because I know that you guys the other night.
No. Did he seriously tell you that?
Yeah, that's why I want to know. Because I was under the impression that it was like two ways.
864?
Oh.
777. Uh-oh. Scott
texted.
He fucked
it. I don't know.
I'm also fucking the flavor.
Cheers. Cheers. I was told that you were really super stoked on it and you really wanted to like... I don't want to say get with him, but...
I wouldn't hit on someone who totally didn't want
it. He said that you invited him over like a few times and he kind of thought...
He kissed me first.
I don't know. I know you're not going to drop the target. Hi. And this is Merwin.
What
number is that?
Fuck you.
I'm joking. There's so much naked toy out here.
Well, most people are staying here because everyone's staying here.
I'm really drunk.
Hello.
But,
I think I'm
hot.
Totally sorry. With me.
I can kind of talk to Nola about like anything. How I feel usually doesn't come out.
Okay, so what's going on?
You're filming us right now?
Yes, I'm filming us right now.
Yes.
Okay, so what's been happening? So what's going on?
Me and Chris talked about like who we are, what we're doing. Okay, I'm your friend. We're gonna be friends because you want to go do what you want to do and stuff.
Long run, everything continues to go the exact same way. You get mad at him, and then you're not mad at him, and then you guys are okay, and then you're mad at him again. But in the long run, I think you guys are gonna end up like together.
We fight and stuff, but like to me, like personally, not because I'm on camera, but because the fact is like. People that fight and make up, those are the ones that freaking stick together.
I know!
It's like, we talk about it, it'd be perfectly fine. And you know what? Even if I was to find somebody else, it wouldn't be...
The end of
it
you
wouldn't
guys.
Be, no, it wouldn't be Chris. That's the thing.
Because you're not together, it hurts you when you guys stay together and then it doesn't work. You love him like a fat kid loves cake.
Exactly! He's my cake! I just wish the cake would love me back.
I know.
Where's my drink? Let's drink that. Maybe it's in the other room. Why does my party feel like it's going so slow? I'm not drunk enough yet.
It's gonna going fast enough for everyone else. I'm having it. I'm having fun.
And then after all that, I had the opportunity to walk into the kitchen and see Chris flirting with Scott. Outside.
In the bathroom.
Terrible.
Yes.
So how do you put taste on that?
Here, you put it in because I know.
God, no, we're not putting that in here.
You go crazy. Like they couldn't get their permits, so then they couldn't get cans in time, so they just canceled.
Oh! I was gonna buy you a stuffed wine, and it was so cute, but then Cody said that you wouldn't appreciate it, so I didn't get it for you.
Yeah, probably.
Wouldn't. Amy and Dave, best friends, my best friends. They're dating. It's kind of awkward because they're crazy and they fight.
I'm dating Dave right now, and so far, so good.
Eric, get the
f- so oh, pretty.
That was
Eric.
Really fun.
He's acting like a drunk 16-year-old, which isn't good. I mean, yet.
You weigh 135?
Oh my god.
I have huge thighs.
I have huge thighs.
What'd you wear?
Look at those. Look at those. Those are big.
Well, how did jeans see
those? Those aren't big.
Okay, for one, Eric and Scott can bite me. Fat thighs. Jesus Christ.
They are. Look at how fat they are.
He's Chris.
Fat fake. Bigger in the shower.
Raise your hand if Chris to videotape. No one.
I'm drunk enough now that Chris and Eric, it's not going to work ever, no matter what we do. We're not going to make it happen.
I heard from multiple people that Scott was saying that I came on to him and he pretty much rejected me, which is really stupid because, first of all, I would never do that, and second of all, even if it had happened that way, why would you go around telling people that? Like, just to make yourself look better?
I don't know.
I'm actually on the real world now. Real world now.
Do you have the same tweezers as...
How's life? How did you say? From Zachary.
Who's that?
Zach
Erickson?
Really,
it got really sad. But
do you
wanna
go?
I looked in the mirror.
Well, see you later. Bye.
See you.
They're all gonna be like, oh, Chris is such a bitch. Things got a little tense between us after that. I'm not the kind of person that just lets people walk all over me either. Like, sorry.
Hey, well, as you were, but I'm sorry. Like, I've never heard somebody talk about themselves so much.
Who, Eric?
Yes.
And then Scott was like, I'm a mannequin. I don't poop. I don't fart. I'm like a mannequin. Hey, Zach. I'm in Merwin's car. We're gonna stop at the center for a bit. Are you there?
Should go get like video of him puking.
Here's something Scott's like. Scott was like, I never do that. I never poop or anything. I'm a little mannequin. And I was like, fuck you, you're a mannequin. I'm gonna punch your plastic face, you bitch. Oh, I'm so mad at him.
Let's go.
Hey, I'm just at home. I had some like free time. This is my room. I don't think Chris really sees how much Merwin's changing. He just is like remembering like when you first met Merwin, you know, Merwin's maybe slightly a little bit more promiscuous now. He's denying actually what he does. But I think, like, there's some tension building there, like, which is, a really negative side effect. Like, it's really shitty that I'm caught in this. The whole Merwin thing got even more complicated because Chris and I were really drunk and we had made out. Me and Merwin had this, like, awkward connection, and then me and Chris had this other awkward connection. I felt like, possibly, why I didn't get invited to New Year's because I think there's like some hostility and some resentment. I don't know.
Colton and Eric?
Cody, you'll never guess what I showed Andy last night. Doggy, no kidding. Dr. Tran. No.
I'm gonna kill you.
Andy's gonna be there. The one that wanted to meet at Scott. Okay, next one.
Was it really that hard? You had Rhyme, Rhyme, Dime.
Have another one.
Video
voice.
Said his name.
And you pointed too.
Okay.
Oh.
I'm gonna take it because I have to go. And when you have to go, I will give it back. That is what I'm gonna do.
No, it's a one use card.
Guys, I can only use it once?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Dan. I moved to Kelowna like in 2008. I met everyone at dances actually. First, I went to dance by myself, wanting to meet people, and then I met, like, Chris, and then kind of my social networking just, like, exploded after that.
Nick, stop being raped. And he's in the army. He will, like, have you assassinated. Grr. Can you do that?
So when I arrived, everyone was, like, way more drunk than me, so I was playing catch-up, and then I just drank a bunch of alcohol, and...
What are you talking?
Want to do this.
Wow, I've never seen so many fags in the same...
Bitch fight.
Have you ever been in a room full of mirrors?
You need to
get maybe pee? I said pee on camera. Fuck!
Fuck me.
I was trying to be attractive and stuff. And second of all, I don't like you.
I'm dating the party, actually.
I like him sometimes, but right now not so much. Is he actually leaving?
That's so dramatic.
Can somebody come with me? Can you just... Somebody come with me.
Where? A little bit. What?
Reaction that right after saying that you're a douchebag. No. Or whatever I said.
No, I just...
Okay, because you are a bit of a douchebag. Okay.
For doing that, yeah, I do.
Okay. You're a bit of a douchebag. I'm a lot of...
Freakishly freaked out by feet is amazing.
Who?
Marlon. Scott Darling. So I want to like...
Sit where?
You're going to see. That's a pretty good dude.
Yeah.
If you ever leave the house again, I have to chase after you. I'm going to let you split your rest and go on the fucking tree. Because my boyfriend is super pissed that I chased after you.
I'm sorry.
I swear to God, if you don't call us again, how old are you? 21. Act like it!
I am!
Just stop! Don't leave the house, run away!
He's water.
People are
telling me
you're mad at somebody else.
What am I? The Red Sea?
No?
Yeah. Here's what's happening.
You are. Bible
British or you are not trying?
No one's mad at anyone.
And then we'll have some kids on the
side.
Number 2.
Nope. Having a heart attack or whatever heart to whatever Amy has. I don't know.
Go upstairs on the deck.
David, go.
No, we had like a heart talk or something. Like we were out in the balcony. I remember I said something along the lines of, I was talking to Amy, it's like, if I was straight, I would totally fuck you. I totally meant that in, like, the compliment sense. Like, I thought she, like, you know, you wouldn't actually say that to someone you'd actually want to, like, screw or somebody, right? So I thought, well, her being, like the biggest fruit fly in Kelowna, I thought she would take it as a compliment. Oh, thanks, Dan. And, yeah, I guess she did not take it the right way, and she got offended, and she's, like, went, like, playing around David, her boyfriend, and I was just like, okay.
Where is my David?
Let's pull that camera. So next time you go to Vancouver, you're not getting it.
Someone take that away from him, please.
Damn.
I'm grasping this very firmly.
No,
Dan, is that alcohol in that?
Do not touch that.
Damn.
Dan, is that alcohol in that?
When
something bad happened? So I seek that one for a minute.
Please.
Are you a mechanic?
Are you taking pictures?
Andy, are you a mechanic?
I'm a weapon specialist.
I'm a what?
What does that mean?
He's in the army.
No.
Are you not gay?
Definitely not.
I'm very gay.
And you're allowed to be.
One second.
You're gay.
Star. If I was in the USA, then no, I would not be allowed in Canada.
Oh, is that how it works? Canada's okay, but USA's
star.
Not?
What is this?
So you're not attracted to any guys in the army?
No, I will not date any people in the army.
Unless they're bros?
American, right?
Ever. Yeah, it's just weird. The hygiene is just...
Later on the night, I got kind of sick. And I was puking and passed out. And after that party, I never got really invited to very much after that. So I felt that's probably one of the reasons why I wasn't invited. I regret it, but I think that actually hurt quite a few like relationships that I had with a bunch of former friends.
Party on the weekend. Taking care of Dan.
Oh, that was ridiculous.
He's like, I'm holding this cup.
Oh, and Zach's back.
Yes, I know, I was talking to him. He's back from Vancouver. Why, what did he say?
Okay, I'm sorry. Everything he sends me has to do with cuddling.
Who, Zach?
Yes.
Oh, I know, he used to do the same thing to me.
He's like, because I was like being nice, I'm like, hey sexy, what's up? He's like, if I was so sexy, you'd be here cuddling with me. I'm like,
you call them sexy?
Well, I don't know, but he's like, be nice to him lately. I'm like, okay, so.
You call them sexy?
Well, I don't know.
This is why people think you're flirting.
I'm not flirting.
But that's what it sounds like. When you say, hey sexy, that's flirting.
Is it really? Well, okay, people should know me by now.
Calories are so not sexy.
I wish I got that on camera.
It is.
We did. Cody was like, I can talk about thunder thighs. Merwin used to be able to talk about thunder thighs. But Scott and Eric cannot talk about thunder thighs.
The thing that is fine is actually in my building at a bachelor at $690 a month.
What are you doing in here?
Do you guys think we should be at the courtroom with Paris?
Do they have a hot tub at the courtroom and a monkey who serves
Oh my god.
What?
I just got a really nasty email. What?
Suddenly I come across this random email from group 12, which obviously someone had made so that they didn't have to use their own email.
I'm sorry if this seems
Who's
really
Jake
bitchy,
Ryan?
But I think someone needs to put you in your place. Honestly, who do you think you are sometimes? You are seriously manipulating a really great guy. If Merwin doesn't start standing up to you when people are around, I promise you people will start to do it for him. You are a total bitch to him and you need to stop or get out of his life.
Who wrote this?
What the fuck? So from all of us, Chris, as stated before, get over yourself.
What the hell, it's a group?
Somebody's pissed at me.
No kidding.
I don't even understand who would send it.
That's a douchey email. Like, my god, get the guts to say it to you in person. Like, that's true, people that we're in a group with.
And
in
like,
group 12.
I didn't think any of these people hated me.
Yeah, we're just down at Starbucks, so do you need me to pick you up right now?
Hello.
No, he'll do anything for you. So, that means even though they stated they tried to throw you off with the... You dated a guy only after meeting him a couple times.
No, you're getting too bitchy about this. Holy shit. Chris is like less pissed off.
Stop being retarded.
Merwin? So it's gotta be.
But what if it's more than one person that wrote the email?
No. It could be. No, they wouldn't have done it in sections. You are taking this.
Because I'm tired of this shit.
It's because all of the people that it could be are his friends.
Second, Merwin, they're not being mean to you, they're being overly protective of you.
Well, no, like, him and Zach disappeared into the room because you and Zach had started to talk about...
What was it?
Oh, it was just about Scott. He was being kind of twatty.
And how I reminded him of Chris. Like, shoddy, like, fucking shoot down my personality. Like, holy crap.
I just bitched him out completely.
He's having another one of his bitchy little rants when, you know, the whole world is against him. And no one loves him, and no one invites him anywhere.
We invited him out every night this week.
Yep. I was talking to him, and he started bitching about you again. And basically wrote exactly the same thing as what was in the email. You and Brandon need to sort out what's going on between you. He actually made a point of saying at one point that everyone knows he likes Merwin, and how that, but you know, he can't move in on that because Merwin's yours.
People just see what they see in group settings. They don't know what we talk about behind closed doors. And it's not really fair for them to be judging about that kind of stuff when they don't know what's been said and what goes on.
He can move in on that all he wants. Merwin's not gonna respond.
Yeah, I know, it's like...
People need to understand that Merwin's his own person.
I know, I don't think people understand that. I get it, because I'm hanging around with you two all the time.
Wow.
All they see is Merwin being upset, or when he's drunk and upset, and it's just, oh, Chris is a horrible person. But that's not how it goes at all. They have no idea.
So I talked to Megan on MSN today, and it wasn't her either.
Oh, yeah. I didn't see anybody doing it there. I just don't understand who could have done it.
Exactly. How drunk are you? You're not drunk at all, are you?
No. Not drunk now.
Ah. What?
Chris,
what?
I would never send an email.
Aww. But, like, it has to be someone that was there that night, right?
Yeah, but...
Well, like I was saying, it was like, it could have been anybody who talked about that night. See, I told you it wasn't Lauren.
Waiting to reply. Mitch, Pua, Nolan, William...
Jesse? You invited Jesse? He doesn't even live in town.
He said he was planning on coming back.
For it.
Okay. Are we still inviting Amy?
We can. I wasn't sure, so I didn't put it, but...
Because after you told me that she could come, I'm like, yeah, you can come up because you're a gay man.
Does she want to?
She's like, I'm a gay man!
I can't even see. I hate drive-thrus. Most confusing things ever made. There is no other window. What the fuck?
No, at the back one.
No. Oh!
Hi.
Park on the other side.
I haven't seen this much snow in ages.
So how did Dan find out?
Oh, Kanan just texted us and he was like, yeah, there's this guy that works at Cooper's that's really pissed he didn't get invited.
Cody said he made a complete ass of himself at Mitch's.
He hit on Amy.
Meat goes in the fridge.
So did Dan text like any of you?
No.
No.
So I texted him, but like, hey, what's up?
Here! Is the hot tub running? I don't care that I'm not gonna be in there. I just thought I'd be
You're talking about Alex?
Talking about Alex's dick every 5 seconds.
Why are you talking about Alex?
What? So the rule of the night is, as soon as he mentions Alex, we slap him.
I was the slutty friend.
Okay, you are. Okay, I'm sorry. You were dancing like a hoe. And they're like, Scott, come here, we're coming for a drink. He's like, no, I'm at the
bar. Well, yeah. I'm sure he doesn't mind.
But Jewel, seriously, can I ask you a question though?
Yes.
Like on camera? Why did you and Alex end?
Not really.
You didn't know at all? Like he broke up with you?
He dumped me. I'm mostly over it. Like somewhat like... Like, he is my first boyfriend. I'm always gonna love him. Like, he's always gonna be in my heart.
If I see him tomorrow night, I'm gonna get, like, punched in the stomach.
Nobody can give me shit for one.
Why are you doing this?
It's like this Magoo.
Oh, stop.
Bro, help him already.
Why are you?
Because I'm already down there.
You're such a flail.
Are you okay?
Chris's condo party. No one really wanted to give me a ride up there, so I actually had to hitchhike.
Downstairs couch.
It's only been a journey and a half to get up here. I forgot that Duel was at the condo party though, and things were just a little awkward.
I'm mommy.
He read an orange.
You get torn apart in Germany. Like, minimum is like 10 inches. God. Yeah, it's like...
I wanted to go to a German sex club when I was there, but the girls I was with did not want to go with them.
I'll see them.
Oh, so helpful.
Mr. Matthews, get on the ground. Body shot!
Two sides, feet deep.
Let go!
Wait, is that liquor?
Who in the room do you think has the biggest and smallest cock?
No, I'm sucking some dick!
What?
Come on! Who wrote this?
You can't.
I am on all four, fuck it!
You got
oh, sorry!
Okay.
Wow, like, that was bad.
You think you'd be the blindest person in bed?
The blindest person in bed. I'm gonna go with Donnie.
He's assuming it's
Donnie and I'll
make out with the person to your right.
Be set, go.
1, 2, 3.
Chug.
Okay. He is naked.
Make the most of it.
Ready? Set.
Go.
2, 3.
3, 4.
You taste like tequila.
You look like a straight boy, Nick.
Yeah, Nick.
What?
So, Alex and Duel are showering together right now.
What?
Yeah.
How do you know?
Because I just went down there and Cody's like, is Alex Duel in the shower? And Scott's like, yeah, I heard them talking about it. So apparently they made up.
They always whine and cry about everything at every party, and then all of a sudden they go and fucking shower together. Like, how does that make anything better? This is not helping the situation at all.
The dance. You coming to the next dance?
I'm gonna try to. I don't have anything white though.
Did you hear about Dawn and Alex?
Yep.
And I was talking to Alex afterwards. I was like, oh, so have fun, you know, showering with Dawn, did you? And he's like, what? Friends can shower together. Well, friends shower together all the time. I was like,
saved water apparently.
Do they now?
Hello?
You got another email?
Hello.
Okay, Danica got an email too.
Wait, and they said something to her too?
Yeah, they talked to her.
Actually, I probably got the same one too, so I'm gonna go get my laptop. Well,
Having all this brought up in the open would make things awkward for everyone who isn't involved. People who aren't involved are already involved.
We know what you're all about, Chris.
All this stuff, and it was just like, first of all, why am I getting this email? I don't think I'm an evil person. And second of all, why can't this person, why is it anonymous? Because the email was anonymous.
Oh.
Fine.
Check. It was yours similar to that.
No, mine was more like sympathetic. Well, who would email Danica? I don't get that.
That's weird.
Oh, apparently she's got like questions about you on Honesty Box and stuff.
We love you and are just trying to help. You should be like, if you love me so much, leave me the fuck alone. I got the email too. From our good friend Jake Bryan at Group 12.
Kay. What does it say?
Oh, it was also sent to Nicole, Megan, me, and Cody.
Why would they send it to you?
That we thought it was.
But
her.
It wasn't sent to Zach.
I never read the email. What was the email?
Okay, it was like somebody emailed Chris and they're like, it was like sent to Chris by like an anonymous email address, like a fake one that somebody made up.
It was made up.
Who knows who it is? And they're like basically telling like every terrible thing about Chris and like going on about how he's such a horrible person.
Does
and like
he still have it?
Yeah, I think he still has it. I want to see it too.
Me too.
Seen it. Okay, we'll ask him.
Well, I bet if we read it, we know who it is, like in a heartbeat.
Well, apparently what I heard is like Maroon and Chris were like reading it and they kind of figured out like, because it like pinpointed like certain things.
Yeah.
So,
who else was there? Wait.
But that's it, exactly. So it was like certain things and it's like, well, there's only this number of people that were here. And oh, this time there's only this number of people that were here.
Yeah.
So like, I haven't really heard anything.
A quiz, a puzzle.
No, I haven't heard anything like more, but.
Oh my God.
What?
Scott is super pissed right now.
So what's happening?
Okay, so Scott Darling said that he's heard from at least 7 or 8 people that I've been spreading this rumor about him being into hard drugs and like wild orgies and like.
Have you?
No.
Oh.
What do you mean?
Well, no.
Have I ever said that to you? Like.
Well, no, I didn't.
What 7 or 8 people have the motive to do that?
Apparently, Zach was one of the people who told Scott that I was spreading that rumor. Zach's digging for dirt on me. Zach's denied everything from the email to like. And I'm sorry, but he did write the email. Like, there is no doubt in my mind that Zach wrote that email. like, good.
Well, I don't mean to add to the drama, but Megan kind of hinted, I think, to me that she wants me to ask you if, Travis can come to your house for the drinking if she does.
Travis.
Yeah.
Look how grandma and my hands are.
Oh my god, so pretty. I just don't know if I like the way he says he talks, like, I think he's better than everyone else. Like, but I don't care why people walk outside. But if Zach comes, I'm not gonna be happy. Like, I'm gonna lock the door.
I'm listening to one person now.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Be quiet.
How are you? Great.
Okay.
Your
things don't work.
It's your fault.
What?
It's a bitch.
I'm
sorry, I was bitching about Kevin. He's pissing me off. He's downstairs right now. We're making entrance. Travis.
Hey.
Like your dress.
Oh, this is what you're wearing?
Pretty much, except there's a little less clothing for the final outfit.
Yeah. I really wish
look
I was drinking right now. I really want to be
Steven?
Do you have
any more stuff, please? If there's
a chance.
I'm
here, I'm sorry.
We're playing.
Maybe it's a form of
the past. Dang it. Nicaragua.
This is why people shouldn't have children.
Amy's here. Amy's here.
Amy.
I am seeking Amy.
Hi. I'm sorry, I took over your bathroom.
Oh.
I turned into a beauty salon.
Do you like my hair?
Yeah.
This is where I got stabbed in his baby. It's good. And my father, that's why my parents are together.
He's lying.
It's cute. So you're getting stabbed in an actual tracheotomy. It's cute.
I love you, Megan.
Yeah.
Everyone in the room is like, size 28.
I have a 34.
Because apparently I'm one of the only people who will straight up tell Chris that he should either date Merwin or let him free. They're living together. Let's try this again. They're living together. They're like, oh my god, we're the best friends ever. Hey, wanna make out? Yes. They get jealous of each other talking and hanging out with other boys when they're drunk. Yeah, that's how it explained dating.
Morning.
Hey.
Hey, how's it going?
Good.
Had fun?
Yeah. Why did you leave?
In all honesty, I don't even remember anymore. It was just...
Are you sure?
I don't know. You and Mark dancing for some reason. I don't know. I looked over and it freaked me out. Well,
but I'm not supposed to get mad when you're dancing with Mark at the condo?
No, I got upset about it.
So there's no problem then? Why?
I'm a little upset. It shouldn't be a problem for you, so I don't say anything. Like I said, it's just a problem on my end.
It would be easier to fix if I know what it is.
No, I don't... That's the problem. I don't know why I care that much.
Well, as long as you're okay now.
And I'm sorry, I don't want to seem weird. That is why I don't bring it up.
Well, have a good day at work, I guess, and we'll talk to you later?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Okay, bye, dude.
Bye.
Oh.
Chris, would you like to do a tequila shot with me?
Sure.
No.
Okay, this is
What's up, people watching this on the World Wide Web? I'm Nick. I'm in a hot tub.
Yeah!
Woo!
Yeah!
Yeah, I
love
it.
No!
Trails
on
your whole face.
No. I thought that was for me.
Yeah, I bet that was for
me. Just do it one more time.
Yeah. Oh my God.
One more time, one more time, one more time.
I only wish this were my camera.
Oh,
oh hello. Just kidding, that didn't happen.
Oh my God, it's so drunk, this is probably what it tastes like.
Is there a dog?
Chris?
No, it's not Dom. You're cute, it's not Dom. It's definitely... I could carry you off to bed.
Hey,
like
Dave.
The man that I am.
Who the fuck's
pet? Somebody's like, Chris needs to leave Merwin alone. And sometimes it's
like... Merwin can play the baby and he cries a lot and it makes you look like a bad person. And...
Everybody needs to fucking get their noses out of it. Because seriously, if he didn't want to take it, he wouldn't. And it just annoys me when everybody's like, fucking Chris needs to, like, leave Merwin alone, blah, blah, blah. And everybody's like, yeah, he's so mean and rude. And I'm like, seriously, guys? Fuck off.
Hello.
Hello.
Zach can be good if he wants to, I know.
It's just that you two don't get along.
You know what, though? Like, I wouldn't have a problem with him if he didn't not like me, because we were friends before he was telling people bad things about me.
Do you have the hip?
He didn't say that, did he?
No. It would be so much better if he did. Next big group outing. One of you is going to get mad. Let's see. Merwin's party. There's going to be too many gay boys in one central place. And you've never met Terry.
Okay, I met Cody's new boyfriend. He's actually really nice. But when I met him, he was like really, really shy. He was like... He's little, but he's like, isn't he like 17 or 18 or something like that?
Let's see, the new boy. Tim.
Tim?
Yeah, because remember I went into Merwin's and I said, oh my God, I met a boy and he's cuter than you. And you got really offended and you said, we'll have to see about that. Okay, he's a little young.
And as lame as it sounds, people when they're younger have less of a pretension a lot of the time. Like, they go through that fabulous phase when they think that everything has to be, like, so right. And, like, some people never grow out of it. Some people, that's who they are. Some people, they are pretentious. Try going out and, you know, like, taking 2 minutes to get ready and, like, throw on a pair of whatever you're wearing and go out. We're not gay and fabulous. You're all boring. You're all trashy. You're all drunken hoes. Just at different periods in your life. Let's face it. You're gay.
Okay, so Cody, did you see him sign on MSN like a million times today?
No.
I don't know if you're, because you came on once, right? And yeah. So I'm like kind of napping, kind of like on MSN. Cody signs out. I'm like, what the fuck? Why do you keep signing in? I'm like, are you checking for something? He's like, maybe. I'm like, are you checking to see if your boyfriend messaged you? He's like, no comment. I'm like, that's so cute.
Singing, this will be the day that I die.
We're going to do this wrong first, though.
What is it? Oh, it's vodka. Mm-hmm.
No, it's white rum. It's a Cinnabon bottle.
Is Nick awesome.
No, he's with Nola, Scott, and Jamie.
I mean, like,
who?
And you're like, oh,
come.
I'm like, no.
I told
him.
Do
it
for
the camera
before
the
show.
So
just
going
to see tomorrow.
Who?
The feels of love I got.
Man.
But, like, when we were sitting over here, he was like, it's okay, Graham, it's okay. He started stroking my leg. I was like, what the fuck?
Steven's boyfriend was stroking your leg?
He stroked my leg when I was sitting there, and Steven was right next to him. Just...
Oh my God. Merwin, are you okay?
But I was the drunk one.
I just always thought that you were going to keep before
him. Everybody always thinks that.
That was fun.
I know. I had fun with the strobe light, even though I couldn't see where I was.
A little bit now.
It's
scooter shots in the kitchen.
And then pulls me around the corner and starts kissing me. He starts like going down to undo my pants. And I was like, let's do shots. And I like drag him into the kitchen. And I'm like, okay, we're doing shots. I have nothing to hide, I'll be honest. And I just don't get why Graham feels the need to tell Merwin about that. And just like, cause shit.
Maybe because you did something to Graham's own shit. So
but then I'm talking to Merwin, and he's just like, I packed up my stuff from your basement. And I'm going home. And I was just like, why? And he's just like, because it's obvious you don't feel the same way I feel about you. So he took his computer, he took everything, and he took it home. Yeah.
Oh. All his stuff's gone.
Wow.
He wasn't lying.
I'd say just let him come back in his own time. In the meanwhile, the boat party is Saturday. I'm
getting ready to go on the boat.
Woo!
And that's Andy. He just followed us.
Go left.
I think he wants to kill me.
Under the tree. He doesn't want to kill you. He wants to do something with a large object.
I just can't see what he's doing. We're having a miniature high school reunion, so you know.
Wondering, happy birthday, Brandon.
I love you in chat. I know! Where's everybody?
So even though I had to get away, I wasn't like mad. I just needed to clear my head. So we were fine to party on the boat and everything.
Hi, Greg.
Hello.
Hello.
Guess who lost his boys? Fuck you all!
$20,
yeah?
$25.
Anybody that jumps off this boat, it's $1,000 fine for you and for Brandon, and the party's over, so stay on board this boat.
No, this already ends up.
Don't be queer about this.
Don't be queer, no.
You can go.
Hey Chris, how's it going?
Hey Eric, I'm pretty good.
I'm fantastic. Why are you covering it?
Covering what?
The camera.
Because it's awkward. Why is it awkward?
Because you are awkward.
I'm awkward? Why?
Your lab needs a little disinfecting.
Language on this.
I'm Chris.
What?
Chris, I'm Elise.
You guys don't know each other.
I'm Chris.
Oh, I really should know you.
No, I just want to kiss someone.
We're single.
But they're all gay, right? They're all gay.
It's really frustrating.
No, we found out the one that we really like thought was attractive and then super attractive.
He was, but he's
you know, like, I thought for sure he was checking me out. You know.
Same.
And then I was like, okay, is he gay? He might be bisexual, right? So I was like gonna go. I actually sent one of my friends to ask him.
He's actually straight up. Well, you can probably.
Yeah, ma'am, nudity! Christopher!
We're
heading to Gunches!
Why? Why?
Because he came up to me and he's like, you stay away from Chris.
Why?
I don't know, because supposedly you said that.
I didn't say anything.
So I am going to wreck him into 2 million pieces.
I'm pretty sure you don't need to do that right now.
You are not staying at his place tonight.
That's okay. I'm going with Maroon to Lauren's house, so it's okay.
Okay, as long as you're going somewhere else but Mr. Blue Shirts.
Andy and James, I think his name was, or something. Anyways, they were fighting about Chris. Shocker.
Do I want a pita?
Yes.
Sure.
Everything on it? Or?
I don't like peppers and mushrooms.
Do you want a pita?
Nope.
It's on me. Are you sure? Are you hungry? Are you sure? Are you actually hungry? You're not hungry?
No.
You need to smile.
I don't
smile. You need to smile.
Hey, smile.
Okay. I don't smile.
Hi, Nick.
How are you?
I'm good.
How are you?
Can you get me a beat? I'm really hungry.
Is it because somebody's not coming home with you? Is that why?
Can I please have a pita?
Well, you seem pretty defensive about it.
Please, can I have a pita?
I'm offering you a pita. You don't want a pita. Okay.
Please, please, can I have a pita? I would like a pita.
Don't slap me like that.
So I heard you made out with Mitch.
Mitch was the one that...
Yeah, he deserves a punch in the balls for that one. And so do you. Did you tell Graham or did Mitch tell Graham?
Mitch told Graham. But now that they're officially in an open relationship.
That relationship, like, I can say it's a fucked up relationship because I was in a fucked up relationship.
That's why I think it's probably going to end soon.
So I've been talking with Graham a lot and stuff, and he told me that they broke up finally.
Well, he texted me and he's like, do you want to hang out tonight? I just want to be with a friend right now. And I'm like, okay, what happened? Did everything go badly or something? He's like, well, technically we're not dating anymore. I just want to hang out with somebody and have a drink.
Okay, wait, if they're over, does that mean that they're... Is Mitch still living there?
I don't know the details. That's probably why he wants to meet someone right now.
Yeah, so there's a new boy that's messaging me.
What's his name?
Nick Fison or something? He's like, he looks like straight, so I'm pretty sure he's in the closet, so he wants to hang out tonight or something, though. He looks 12, but apparently he's legal, so.
Oh.
And Mitch wants to go out clubbing tonight, he was texting me, so I was like, hey, let's all go out. So, I don't know. That could be interesting.
Pizza!
Oh, pizza.
The chat.
Am I you going clubbing with Mitch?
I might. Are you going to Graham's? Don't you want
to? You seem pretty adamant that you're going with Mitch, and I don't know, so...
I don't know.
Booze and you two don't mix.
Oh!
I just wasn't enjoying what I was doing. You were.
Who said I was enjoying it?
You were doing it.
Doesn't mean I was enjoying it.
Then why were you doing it?
I go to school, it doesn't mean I enjoy it.
That's not the same. You can't help not going to school.
And I can't help it when someone kisses me.
Yeah, you can.
How many times have you gone along with stuff? What about when you made out with Eric?
Yeah, 3 seconds in me laughing and leaving are different than, like, making out and a little bit of fumbling.
I was there.
And then...
It wasn't 3 seconds. You made out with him for a good minute.
No.
Yeah.
This is Nick.
So the camera knows. Hi, camera. This is Nick. Tell us. Is there something we should know?
No.
Yeah.
I'm not crazy.
You're not crazy?
What happened?
Oh, well, that's boring.
I'm not crazy.
Or hit the home button.
I play with guns and helicopters for fun, though.
That's a little bit crazy.
You like to shoot guns?
I have never shot a gun.
Ever shot a gun?
No.
You ever wanted to shoot a gun? I'm Nick, and I growing up, I never knew any gay people, and it was around when I was 15 when I went on a cruise around the world. That's when I realized I was gay. And growing up in Winfield, kind of hard for me. I dealt with a lot of sexual repression, and it was great to come out and meet these guys because they opened my eyes to the gay community in Kelowna that I had was completely oblivious to.
Are you coming to the dance?
Am I going to what dance?
Yeah, it's a gay dance. It's like $25 because it's Pride and there's a ton of people, so...
He's like, you're so drunk, stop drinking! And then the next thing, he's like puking his guts out.
Because he handed me an extra beer. I run to the bathroom.
And then he puked for like 3 hours.
Like, literally.
It wasn't 3 hours.
Yes, it was.
No, it was not, man.
Oh, really? What were you doing?
Anyways, it wasn't 3 hours.
Graham was like in the bathroom.
The only club I've been to is Liquid Zoo.
Is that a club? Or
it's the strippers.
It's the strippers.
Yeah,
I
don't
carry
a gun.
I decided it was about time that I met someone who was like me. I decided I should, get out and meet some people who were gay. And I found Chris on Facebook and I sent him some messages.
Did you meet him on Manhunt? Were you on Manhunt?
No, he just messaged me on Facebook.
I saw
is he hot?
Nick Jeff's profile, I don't know, he commented on his status or whatever, and I clicked on it, I was like, I don't know why. And then I saw the groups he was in, it was like, gay men who like Amy's boobs. I was like, whoa.
You will meet Amy, she's my roommate.
Okay.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, well.
Oh, that's surprising.
I was like, okay, well,
that makes my
holy,
really.
This guy's gay, he's from Kelowna, blah, blah, blah. First, I don't know anybody who's gay. I was like, started looking through his pictures, and I saw pictures of you, and I was like, who is that? and then I messaged you for the first time, and that's how it all started.
It was great coming out here and finally meeting someone who was gay, and ever since then, I've sort of been welcomed into the community, I guess.
Well, I'll call you tomorrow.
Okay.
I gotta begin my journey.
Alright, well, it sucks that you're going, but we'll see you tomorrow, probably, maybe.
I'll come out and see you guys tomorrow.
Awesome.
Okay. Okay. I'll walk you to the door, actually, because I feel rude not doing that.
Bye. Bye. It was nice meeting you guys.
You're going to the next dance?
I don't think so.
Why not?
I don't know. There's nothing fun and I get ditched.
I'll dance with you.
No, you won't. You'll be with, like, all your other people.
What people?
Lots of people come up to you and are just like, hey, let's go dance. Or they'll, like, see you on the floor and they'll just go and dance with you.
Merwin, you're cute.
Yeah, okay. When I meet somebody else who says that to me, then I'll believe it.
What have I done to you?
Wait,
okay, fine. Why? What have I done to you?
What is wrong?
Why have I done
happen?
Not because you're rich.
Okay, I guess.
Not that octave.
Is there a promo?
Yeah.
What?
Can't believe I'm falling down. Can't believe I'm falling down.
You can take a picture of me later when I'm done.
Okay. Graham and Mitch?
Yeah, and they
Graham and Mitch are gonna be both together forever. Apparently, they're gonna take some time apart and they're gonna end up together one day.
Yeah, they talked about it. So
they've,
yeah.
Like, they've talked this through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Do you know who else said that?
Wait, let me guess.
You and Kieran.
Yeah.
Oh, I was thinking somebody famous. By the time it's not gonna happen, if it doesn't happen, they're both gonna be happy somewhere else. So either way, thinking this is gonna make them happy whether it works or not.
What about weird as you wanna do something that
everybody, this is Nick.
Hello.
How's it
going?
Hi Nick.
Yeah, you
think
you're
trying
to cry?
This is David.
Shut the fuck
up.
I'm Cody.
Have you met Cody?
Have you met Cody? I'm like, wow, it feels like people were mourning.
You know what, when you turn it into a bad thing, it is a bad thing.
Yeah, I know.
Now you know there's something bad. Cody's talking more people than me.
Well, obviously. Half the town knows you. Thank you.
Fuck her.
Yeah.
Fuck him.
No. Ow, you.
What just happened? What did you say?
I said
once was enough.
Come on, you gotta start laughing at it sometime.
No.
No,
hey.
Him.
Oh.
So are you gay or bi or what?
I'm drunk.
Let's start this.
No.
Have you had sex with a girl?
Yes, I have.
Have you with a guy?
I've never had sex with a guy.
Well, that doesn't mean you haven't blown a load with a guy.
No. Chris is the first guy I've kissed. And that was...
Really?
3 years ago.
Mm. They like each other and they're just taking a break.
Okay. Nicely, right?
These two do it nicely. I don't know. This one doesn't. This one definitely plays with big boy claws.
Only if they're deserved.
Okay, we're all doing shots now.
Oh, okay, fine.
Cocaine, speed, did meth once by accident.
Meth?
I've never done meth.
Mmm. It was my first time doing mushrooms.
Wow, that's why I like coming out and hanging out with you guys, though. It's because you guys don't do that shit.
Well,
yeah,
like,
yeah.
All my buddies in fucking Winfield, they do so much blow, and ever since I've been hanging out with you guys, I haven't done it for the past 3 weeks, because I don't know, I've been hanging out with you guys. I hardly smoke in front of Chris.
Well, if it's good for you, feel free to call any of us up.
Oh my god. Merwin! Oh my god! Merwin!
Yeah, I think we might need to walk this guy home.
No?
Dude, do you want us to take you home?
Yeah, you need someone to take you home or what? We are discussing the fucked upness of Chris and Merwin, Chris and Travis, Chris and anything that walks, talks, breathes, or has a bum. Has a bum.
Bum.
So Merwin needs space. He needs space. Chris is actually going to be a man and step up to the plate. Chris is now deleting because I talked up him to Nick last night. He is deleting one message from Travis, which is a big deal because he has like 90 saved messages from Travis on his phone. Yeah, that's right, 90.
They're just
a memory?
Hey, I'm gonna keep a memory around of this time that, you know, I got this giant splinter in my foot. Yeah, it was amazing. Did you like that time? Yeah, well, the time I was, like, running on the deck, it was really fun. Then I got this giant splinter, and it hurt me forever, and I got an infected and oozed. Yeah, I'm going to keep a memory from that. No, not a good idea.
Well, we were talking about reading. Apparently, Zach still thinks I'm, like, the most evil person ever. Like, Zach's, like, told to Cody, he's like, why do you keep bringing Chris over here?
No, he's still bitter about the whole, like, me thing, too.
I want to be friends with Mitch. I don't like.
Really?
I don't want to have issues with people.
I don't know him well enough.
I feel like I don't know him well enough to like. Believe judge. Me, I have enough. It's just because I've been living with him.
And
Graham's been so. Like,
oh, you're definitely looking at pictures.
He keeps asking me a million times what I'm doing tonight, and keeps asking me the same questions over and over again. And then I tell him the same answer. I'm like, maybe if you ask me four more times, I'll give you the answer. Differently. Fuck off. Oh, I love you, goodnight. I say to him, I'm not dating you. Like, yeah, you're right, you're single. Go hook up with whoever you want. Oh, I intend to. Oh wait, you're not going to Vancouver.
I'll visit.
You better come visit. It's gonna be so much fun. Every kind of gay person is there.
But like, what do you hope to find there?
A boy.
Like a boy to date?
A boy to sweep me off my feet. Someone that doesn't just want to have sex on the first date.
How's Graham taking you leaving?
I don't know. He wants me to stay. He thinks I won't ever come back to him once I go to Vancouver, but what's your ideal place to meet your dream boy?
It's changed. Like, I always used to want to meet, like, a guy that I didn't know that he was gay, and then, like, one day it would just happen, and it would be so romantic, and, like, because, like, in high school, it was always, like, the guy that was, like, you never knew if guys were gay, so it was always, like, the guessing game.
It's true. Scandalous, showing up to the club looking glamorous.
Haters need to hate like fish need to swim. I went through a couple months, maybe a year, about caring about what everyone else thought about me and what everyone was talking about me, but let's face it, gay boys fucking gossip. They're always going to be something around about you. I've heard rumors about me go around, and I just laugh about it, because a lot of the shit that you hear about yourself is fucking hilarious. You're like, wow, I didn't sleep with those people. Like, I don't have the clap.
How come? I was talking to Mitch today, and he was like, oh, are you still fighting with Nick?
We're fighting. Apparently someone told him we're fighting. I wish someone would tell me why we were fighting.
Like, I don't understand why people make it such a big deal. No skin off of my back. If people aren't going to get to know me. A lot of people haven't gotten to know me because I'm a huge slut. I don't give a fuck. I'll get to know them, and unless I have a gigantic confrontation about them, I'll really just shrug it off.
So basically, I thought I should just like film another quick update. I was wanting to be nice and like really sensitive to Merwin's feelings, but I guess I've learned my lesson though. Be very choosy of who you hook up with, especially in this town.
I heard from multiple people that Scott was saying that I came onto him and he pretty much rejected me behind my back, and he didn't say anything about it to my face. I'm not the kind of person that just doesn't say what I think.
I don't have anything to say.
You're frustrating, Tom.
Chris is a little bit timid at some points. Until he gets mad or something pisses him off.
That's perfect. That's perfect. My last one is just because of my
fucking dick.
I don't know why boys are so head over heels with Chris. I'm not mean!
Chris really, 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 really enjoys the game, but he doesn't know that he's playing the game, and it's kind of a little bit annoying.
Chris, you don't have to believe me, or you don't have to trust me.
You're not lying.
I'm not lying to you.
You're not lying about what happened.
I'm up front and I say what I think. If I think Scott's being a dick, I'm gonna say so.
It was because of a misunderstanding, and because one person lied to somebody else. It wasn't my fault, and it wasn't Chris's fault.
Okay, I didn't want to not like you. I honestly did.
It was with Chris on Valentine's Day. Kind of made out, but I don't know, I was kind of into it. He was kind of into it, but nobody kind of wanted to admit it. I have to keep a certain persona, because I'm best friends with Cody. So Cody's a slut, so I have to look like I'm the slut as well. So you know what, I think it's annoying, because everybody else just realizes they can't play the game like Chris does. And if we could actually play the game like Chris does, actually have these boys interested in us, it wouldn't be the same.
So Dave broke up with me at my house the other day. I'm okay, or pretending to be okay, I guess. Mostly I'm just kind of pathetic, mostly kind of just pathetic. But I'm gonna go to the dance that's coming up and try and be fun Amy that everybody loves to hate. And guess hang out with my friends that still love me and get drunk.
Skate shoots right now. While we walk to the dance.
There's a lot of people that I wanna say fuck you. Too, but I'm gonna hold back. Cause the people, there is the people that are a lot more important. So drunk.
Bitch.
Oh, Chris, I'm so drunk.
See this? I don't know whose this is. I'm gonna drink it.
No more liquor. No more liquor.
Okay,
you want to come here? I'll answer the door for you. People that have sex are just wrong.
Amy.
Sex is bad.
I
have to try my shoes. Amy, look how sexy you are.
I'm worried about size.
A lot more important. Just let me walk. Walk me.
And I heart Chris, and I heart Matt, Brandon.
You know what?
And I heart Nick, and I heart everybody.
And I want to say, if you're going to the dance, and you have a problem with anything that either of us have to say, fuck you. Just saying.
I love you, bitch.
I love you too, motherfucker.
Dude, don't drop it. Oh my god, Amy. But have you not heard Cody though?
Has he? I'm sure he's given you crap about it.
He has. Yeah, I've had some conversations with Cody. Some drunk ones.
What did he say?
Well, it's not good on your part.
Well, obviously not. Like, I know what people say about me. They do. Everyone
Wrong.
Says different stuff. You don't know what people say to me.
Wrong. Yeah, but you don't know what people say behind your back.
I actually do. Word gets back to me. Just give it to me.
He said, well, he's not the only one who said this. But I hear that you play with guys' heads and then you just move on.
Yeah, no, I've heard it all. People were just like, oh, you have a new boy every week. And I was like, no, I went on two different dates with two different guys that I just met.
It doesn't mean you're taken if you go out on a date with someone.
So I need to ask you, what was with you and Cody for a while? Like, it's just like, because I met you and we all hung out and then suddenly you were just like gone and you were just with Cody all the time.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. He's a pretty open person, so It was easy to sort of, you know, experiment. Oh, I wrecked my fortune. I liked that one too.
What did it say?
It said, your life will become, soon your life will become more interesting. I loved that fortune.
I need the opposite of that fortune.
Why? You want less interesting?
I have too much right now. Much. Did you just throw your fortune out the window?
I did.
Dude, I kind of regret it now.
I regret it now.
You're gonna have to die now.
Magically add 500 horsepower to his
career.
I have decided that gay people, gay guys in specific, are my people because I don't like hanging out with girls. I want to hang out with guys because guys are just awesome, but I don't want to sleep with all of them. So with gay guys, I don't have to sleep with them. So gay guys are my people.
There's some sort of homosexual contract going on over there. It's extremely interesting.
Testimonial on dick.
That's the noise that happens when Nick puts his visa in the machine. I've run out of money!
I like guys, I don't like being friends with girls, but it's so much fun to be friends with gay guys, because they're just like the perfect guy. They're the perfect guy, Chris.
So, we just got a message right now that Zach is moving out on us at midnight when we're out clubbing, because we just gave our notice today that we gave him a month's warning, and he is, apparently, we just got a message that he is moving out. So we're just parting at the clubs being like, okay, we gave him a month's notice, we thought that was fine, we thought that was fair. Zach apparently does not think that's fair, and he's moving out as we speak, and is willing to fuck us over hardcore. This is fucking ridiculous. I am. Are you?
That's the only way I'm gonna give him a full month's rent. Because he's not trustworthy.
Okay, my roommate, the one that I told I gave my notice to today, is moving out right now. I am furious. Because I think that's probably what Amy and Scott are taking so long with, because they're freaking the fuck out.
Okay.
I thought you had them.
Your keys are inside. If I go pee and say nothing.
Oh, okay. Well, I have to go get my keys.
I gave my keys to Amy.
Did Amy
go
inside? Okay, I promise I won't, like,
no, look, please get Brandon's keys.
I will.
If you're going to make legal binding messages, you might not want to try to deke out before you're supposed to.
I'd like to say a statement. Legally, he has no right to do any of this. You didn't sign a contract. You did not sign this lease. He cannot do any of this. That's it. That's all I have to say.
You good?
Yeah.
Lying in what kind of way?
No one's not going to do anything stupid.
Lying about.
I'm just
lying
saying,
about everything, but, and everything's not really fine.
It doesn't matter about the gay
community. It's not even social.
You just the gay community doesn't matter. What matters is the fact that you have the law on your side. He cannot break his own lease agreement. You are not on the lease. You and Dave have not signed anything.
No, you're not. But yet you're instigating things.
Okay, you guys. No. You guys both. Water.
Sweetie, but they
look, water.
I know.
Why is one?
This is beyond gay drama. This is a diva cunt drama. Zach, this is me talking. I am going to do everything I can to make your life a living hell.
Okay, so I wanted to state what happened with the apartment and why everything went down the way it did. Basically, what happened with the apartment is rather unfortunate, and it was... I loved that apartment so much.
He ran out with the rent for the month, plus he ran away with their damage deposit, which technically he doesn't have to reimburse the damage deposit because they didn't have anything in writing.
But it didn't work out. People have their differences, and sometimes their differences are not fixable.
I never said anything about him. I didn't stop talking to him at all throughout all of this. I'd be at his house and he'd walk into the house and I'd like be like, "Hi, Zach." He'd walk right past me and ignore me. And you know what, Zach? People like me. They don't like you.
I got nothing right now. Saying that A, it's like we fucked him out of money when he stole from us. B, when he trash talks Scott to a whole bunch of guys in Van.
He went to my friends, not his friends, my friends in Vancouver, and started trying to spread shit about me. And if he really wants to have, like, an actual dialogue, like a confrontational dialogue, bitch, I'm right here. I gotta do is call me, cause I'll fucking pull your weave right out.
I imagine God.
So wait, why did Ben text you to help me?
Cause I asked Ben who was he doing.
You asked him?
Yes, I asked him.
So randomly dancing, you thought, hey, I'm gonna ask Ben what he's doing.
You, it's not your drama tonight.
Well, it's my thing. No, don't even bring that as drama. I was asking a question. Don't make it all about that.
Zach, it's Chris. Are you okay? What's going on?
I don't think anything would fix it.
You don't think any time you and Zach would be friends?
Probably not. He really fucked me over good. He really fucked Cody over.
There's nothing that can ever make it better because you have stolen from people.
At the end of the day, it sucks, but everyone makes their decisions and everyone makes their choices and that's what we live with.
Scott, you need to relax, Scott. No, that's
now
what I said to him.
Scott all wired up.
I don't know, I just felt that it was really one-sided and that people jumped to conclusions. And life lesson here. Life is meant to be fun, but it's taking that fun in stride. And living with Cody was a lot of fun, and hanging out with Cody prior to living with Cody was a lot of fun, but the fun just really didn't stop, and I think that caused a lot of the avalanche that happened at the end. It was just kind of a big snowball that rolled down the hill.
New message.
Hey, it's just me. Calling because I have kind of had enough with hearing about everything that everybody is saying about you. I don't know, I just think that we should go our separate ways. Nick is done too. He's had enough of seeing me like this. I don't know if he'll be hearing from him much either, but this is too much. Can't do it anymore. Can't. Bye.
Hey, so you call him sexy?
I don't know.
This is why people think you're flirting.
That was like a piece of dust.
And some cobwebs.
Oh, where are we going?
He would see that I'm holding up this thing of a banana split from Denny's that he loves.
Hey Dave! What the fuck is
that? As for Kelowna, it has some good people and it has some bad people like everywhere else. It's just, Kelowna's just not for all people.
I miss David.